36,000 to 40,000 deaths.
Yeah, right.
Now,
that's the regular flu.
That's the regular flu.
That's the regular flu.
36,000 to 40,000 die of the regular flu every year.
Correct.
That's right.
Correct. Worldwide, you know, it's quite a bit higher. I didn't get that, you know, get that amount up before I left because I was trying to get down here. But and they also said about 200,000 people hospitalized with serious conditions.
Right.
In the CDC reports, they're factoring in roughly the same amount. But however, we're in a pandemic already.
Right.
So, and they're also saying that the people that are the most at risk for this flu are the standard ones that are at risk for the regular flu. People with asthma, heart problems.
Allergies.
Allergies. Here, CDC, certain groups are more vulnerable to swine flu, and this is also with the regular flu, including children under 2, pregnant women, and people with health problems like asthma, diabetes, and heart disease.
Right.
Now, if you notice, most of those 500 deaths were with pregnant women, people with heart disease, and diabetes. There have been a couple people that have been completely healthy that they claim died from the swine flu that were completely healthy and no other underlying conditions, but they said autopsy reports are ongoing. And they never release any of the information after that.
Okay.
So it's just interesting information that it's what is
it doesn't,
exactly
it doesn't add up, does it?
No,
it's
doesn't.
Not adding up. These emergency powers, national state of emergency. By the way, you know about let me see here. Before August 20th, I had sent out an email to everyone. I sent out an email blast to everyone on my email, and I emailed them the meeting that was going to be occurring in Washington, D.C., I believe it was. You're shaking your head, yes, because you remember that. And it had the government people were going to be there, the private industry, the pharmaceutical companies, by the way, put this whole shindig on. They paid for the whole thing. You know, it was really wonderful of them, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I told everyone, you need to read every piece of literature here, the whole website that these people have up. Because what they're saying, exactly what they were saying they were going to study and do there, has now materialized right here before our eyes. This is exactly what they were talking about doing. They were holding classes on how you're going to get people to take the vaccine who were hostile towards it, how you were going to quarantine people, you know, how you were going to take care of the first responders first. You know, but come to find out, a lot of the first responders are saying, we're not taking that vaccine, we're not taking that shot, forget it. You know, we're not taking that thing, you know.
The first responders don't want to take it.
Yeah, especially when we see that you've got squalene in there and you've got some other, like, contaminated bacteria and you've got thermosol in there and
Guillain-Barré syndrome.
Yeah, Guillain-Barré syndrome. And
it comes back to the people actually, you know, not following, something that they're told to do.
Right.
Knowing that it's more important to do the right thing. You know, there are soldiers out there who are dying every day, and I love them. Thank you for serving our country. But some of the orders that are given are sometimes incorrect orders from a superior.
Right.
And it is their duty to disobey those orders if indeed they know that those are not to be, followed. And so it just basically comes back to people saying no. And if it means, punishment coming your way, whatever it might be, then so be it. But the bottom line is we have to stand up for what's right and stop, cowering to, out of fear to these people and to everything else that, is going to continue to push us down the road to tyranny.
Right.
And that's what this comes back to. You know,
absolutely.
Our forefathers were not men of fear.
No.
They faced the greatest army in the world. The odds were tremendous. Nobody ever gave them a chance. And they looked at each other and said, we don't care. We're going to go for it because we know that this is more important. And they were men of stature. They were all kinds of men. I mean, but the men who signed the Declaration of Independence and such like that, the leaders back then, they were not poor men. These were rich men. These were men of very good stature and had everything to lose. And
right.
Yet they said, okay. And that's what we need. We need good people out there. And I believe they're out there, Dan. And that's why, guys like that we have here today, they give me hope because I know that there are numbers of people out there who are getting this, who understand it, who are willing to take a stand. And we need these numbers to continue to grow tremendously.
Absolutely.
And we need them to grow tremendously now.
Yeah.
Not 6 months from now, not a year. We need everybody today. If you're listening out there right now, don't sit back and just give it another, no. Call, you know, get involved. Go to the CPL, you know, Florida website and call Dan or myself or whoever. Just get involved. Whether it's the Constitution Party or another, get involved. I love the 912ers. You know what?
Yep.
Great. Keep up the good work. Keep learning about the Constitution. Keep learning your rights and start fighting for this stuff because it's coming, folks. It's coming.
It is. There's a good thing on that website as well. To stay updated on a lot of this information, we actually have a current news section, a blog on there, that a lot of this information,
on
the CP Florida website.
CPFlorida.com.
Yeah, CPFlorida.com website.
Right.
There's a current news section, which is a blog that has articles like this and stuff like that, so you can stay updated as to everything that's going on.
That's great.
And, you know, one other thing, as you guys were talking about with the swine flu vaccine and why are they releasing this, there is another motivational factor behind it. Money. These pharmaceutical companies are going to make a ton of money off this vaccine.
Are you kidding me?
And who's paying for it? The taxpayers.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's another motivational factor.
Yeah. We're going to go to break here in just a couple minutes, but I want to read you all something because I think, you know, here we are. We've got the deck stacked in here, right? We're all Constitution Party members. Yeah, all right. You know, but we're that for a reason. We're all belong to the Constitution Party for a reason. I want to read something to you that our national chairman, Jim Clymer, he made a statement to World Net Daily News. Will Americans follow orders to take flu shots? Alarmist language sparking fears of mandatory vaccinations and quarantines. The Constitution Party, a fast-growing alternative to the dominant Democratic and Republican parties in many elections, has come out strongly in opposition to any mandatory injections of potential toxic H1N1 swine flu vaccine, citing the Fourth Amendment, which says, here, I love this because our national chairman is citing the Constitution, you know what I'm saying? This is great. Citing the Fourth Amendment, which says, the right of the people to be secure in their persons shall not be violated, Constitution Party National Committee Chairman Jim Clymer said the issue isn't that complex. It comes down to the most fundamental of all freedoms. If government can force potentially dangerous substances into our bodies, what then can't government do to us, he said.
Right.
And I could go on and read more about this, but I'm telling you, God bless you, Jim Clymer, for standing up and making a national statement.
Absolutely.
I'm proud of the Constitution Party
Absolutely.
Because we made that statement. We're absolutely 100% against this and forcing fellow Americans to do this. You know, I wish some of the other parties would stand up and you know, make a stand like we are. If we all stood together and really took back our country, nobody could stand against us. But we have to do that all together. We're going to go to a break here for 5 minutes, and maybe John has that special song I asked him to play, Ball of Confusion. Some of you may remember that by the Temptations. What do you think, John?
It's been playing.
He's got it on. How long have you had that on for?
Are we on break here?
Are you serious? Yeah, I want to bring that chair right here. Because if you would, please. Let's get it in a big stool. Let's do it here. Unemployment rising fast, the Beatles' new records of gas. And the only safe place to live is on an Indian reservation. And the band played on.
Eve of destruction, tax deductions.
City inspectors, bill collectors,
hard coding and man population out of hand.
Suicide, too many bills, hippies moving to the hill. People all over the world are shouting in the war.
And the band plays.